I don't understand why Oliver Stone, who lives in a country that affords him the ability of with freedom of speech to go out there and make movies, would glorify someone like Hugo Chavez that doesn't support the people of Venezuela. He manipulates the people of Venezuela. I am shocked and disturbed, frankly, that this movie was made and others that Oliver Stone has made to try to glorify some of these people who would like to see our way of life completely changed.
It is a kind of two against one here. So Oliver will be allowed to defend his opinion. But Jesse, what are your thoughts?
Well, first of all,
do you know Chavez?
Representative, it's governor. Thank you.
Do you know?
There you go.
Do you know?
I prefer my title, just as you do yours.
Governor, do you know?
You can call
Chavez?
Me Connie, Jesse.
No. No, I've never met Chavez, but I will make this statement. I watched Oliver's film this weekend, and I think this film should be mandatory viewing for every high school senior in the United States of America. That's how strong I feel about it. Because the key to Oliver's film is not Hugo Chavez. The key to this film is the lying manipulation of our mainstream media and how they flagrantly lie to us. And I'm a person that knows the experience well, being an independent.
Do you think they've conned Connie Mack?
I think Connie Mack is going, off the U.S. media and what they tell him, because I would ask Connie if he's ever been there. Has he met Mr. Chavez? I've been to Cuba. I've met Fidel Castro over the objections of the Bush administration, where Otto Reich had the gall to say we were going down there to sample the sex trade, which I asked for an apology and never got.
Connie, do you know Chavez?
No, I don't, but for the governor to suggest that this should be mandatory for all of the our students.
Aye.
Again, it's shameful. I don't know where you are. I don't understand what it is that's in your mind when you want to subject our children to the thoughts and ideas of someone like Hugo Chavez that again supports the FARC.
Oh, so we should practice censorship? Your advocation is censorship?
No, your advocation.
We shouldn't allow our kids to see what goes on.
One at a time.
Governor, your advocation is for.
It's called knowledge.
Governor, you are saying that you want to make this part of the curriculum. Are you kidding me? What happened to the greatness of America? I mean, I don't understand. I really don't understand this, Larry.
How about when our media used to be the fourth branch of government? Our media was there to be the check of watching the other three. But our media today, mainstream, is not that, Larry. Okay. They are bought and sold. I'll give you examples. When I was an independent governor in Minnesota, I wrote my autobiography when I got in office. The mainstream media accused me of profiteering from winning that office.
Wait.
2 months later, John McCain comes through on a book tour, and they herald his book. And yet, because I don't belong to these two parties, I get chastised by
the
mainstream.
You want to defend Chavez,
Larry, if
all
I may
right,
real
quick. Connie, go ahead.
If I may real quick. Governor, that's the way it is in politics. I don't care what party you're in. If you're a Republican, a Democrat, an independent, you're going to get scrutinized by the media. But isn't it a great
thing
isn't it a great thing that we have freedom of speech? And that you and I can have this conversation. In Venezuela, they can't. Hugo Chavez won't allow this to happen.
Have you ever been there?
Governor, Oliver, is he right? Could this debate take place in Caracas?
Yes. Three quick points. Absolutely. It's the most colorful media. You can say anything you want in Venezuela. Anything. Number two, he didn't steal the election because you know what? They have a better election process than we have because they not only have electronic voting, but they have a paper ballot that comes from the electronic. So they have a two-fold system. And it's been monitored by three international organizations, so forget about elections. And then the bigger point, the one that I think Connie misses, is that, look, I went to see eight presidents, seven of them of South American countries. They have supported this guy unilaterally. They like him. America is the one that's on the other side of history here. We are fighting all of South America except for Colombia and Peru and Chile.